The universe consists of 1 billion galaxies, 77 billion miles across. And every galaxy is made up of 1 billion zillion stars. And around these stars circle 8 billion planets. And of all these planets, the greenest and the pleasantest is the planet Earth. In the system of Sol, in the galaxy known as the Milky Way. And it was to this world that creatures of an alien planet came to conquer and destroy the very heart of civilization. It was a day like many another, and Mr. and Mrs. Samuel Brain Sample were a perfectly ordinary couple leading perfectly ordinary lives. The sort of people to whom nothing extraordinary ever happens. And not the kind of people to be the center of one of the most astounding incidents in the history of mankind. So let's forget about them and follow instead the destiny of this man. Harold Potter, gardener and tax official. First victim of creatures from another planet.
Quite well, I believe.
Oh, yes, quite well. He was my husband.
Yeah. And he never showed any inclination towards being a Scotsman before this happened.
No, not at all. He was not that sort of person.
He didn't wear a kilt or play the bagpipes.
No.
He never got drunk at nights or brought home black puddings.
No, not at all.
He didn't have an inadequate brain capacity.
No, not at all.
I see. So, by your account, Harold Potter was a perfectly ordinary Englishman without any tendency towards being a Scotsman whatsoever.
Absolutely, yes. Mind you, he didn't always watch Dr. Finlay on the television.
Aha! Well, that's it, you see. That's how it starts.
I beg your pardon?
Well, you see, Scottishness starts with little things like that and works up. You see, people don't just turn into a Scotsman for no reason at all.
No further questions?
I've got to tell you.
What is it, darling?
It's Daddy. He's turned into a Scotsman.
What? Mr. Llewellyn?
Yes, Charles. Help me. Please help me.
But what can I do?
Surely, Charles, you're the chief scientist at the Anthropological Research Institute at Buckley Down, an expert in what makes people change from one nationality to another.
So I am. This is right up my street.
Oh, good.
Now, first of all, why would anyone turn into a Scotsman?
For business reasons?
No, only because he has no control over his own destiny. Look, I'll show you.
I see!
Yes, so this means that some person, or persons unknown, is turning all these people into Scotsmen.
Oh, what kind of heartless being could do that to a man?
I don't know. All I know is that these people are streaming north of the border at the rate of thousands every hour. If we don't act fast, Scotland will be choked with Scotsmen.
Ooh!
Soon Scotland was full of Scotsmen. The overcrowding was pitiful. Three men to a caber. For the few who remained, life was increasingly difficult. Ha ha ha.